Hi there, I'm Jennifer from savorwithjennifer.com, and today we are making beef stew. Now, this isn't just any stew. This beef stew is full of red wine, mushrooms, beef stock, onions, herbs, spices, garlic, and it is incredible. To begin, we are going to begin by browning a quarter pound of bacon. The reason we're browning bacon today is because we are going to take chuck steak cubed into 1.5 to 2 inch pieces, fat trimmed. We're going to dust it with flour, salt, pepper, and then we're going to brown our chuck cubes in our bacon drippings. Also, the bacon just adds a really nice layer of salty smoked flavor to this stew that you'll just have to taste to see. Okay, our bacon is about crisp. Our beef is cubed nicely. We're going to sprinkle it with flour, salt, pepper, and then we're going to brown it in the bacon drippings in 2 batches. The reason for the 2 batches is we don't want to crowd the pan where you're going to cause your meat to cool the pan temperature down a lot, and it will steam as opposed to brown. Browning the meat is where you're going to pick up a lot of extra flavor, and that's why you do it as opposed to just putting it straight in liquid and boiling it. All right, that looks delightful. I'm gonna massage that flour in a bit. We're going to take our bacon out of the grease and then put the first batch of beef in. We're going to flip our beef so that it can brown on all sides. And while we're doing that, we're gonna start on the mushrooms. This can be a little smoky. The bacon drippings are cooking at a medium-high temperature because we want to brown our beef, not steam it. The mushrooms have been cleaned up of any extra debris with the end trim, and we're going to simply cut them in half. After the second batch of beef has browned, we're going to remove it and add our mushrooms. We're going to sprinkle them with salt, and as soon as they have begun to brown themselves, remove them to our meat tray, and then we will work on the onion and carrots will go in next. First round of beef looks perfect. We're going to take it out and add the next one. All right, while that beef finishes up, we're going to mince our 2 onions, white or yellow, peels removed, and obviously. And then 1 pound of peeled fresh carrots. I am a little bit picky about not using baby carrots. I think that the flavor is just a little bit different. I think that whole fresh carrots just taste better. So that's what I do. All right, our cubes of beef have a really nice brown crust, and the smell is fantastic on all sides. We're gonna go ahead and pull those, and next we're gonna add our mushrooms. Now, depending on how fatty your bacon was, if you have drippings left, we're not gonna add any additional. However, if your pan is beginning to look dry right before you add the mushrooms, we're gonna add 1 tablespoon or 2 of butter. A lot of hard work. Carrots are peeled. We're gonna give them all a nice cut. I don't like to go too small in the carrots because they're gonna be in there the full time with a rather large pieces of beef. And I want them to maintain their shape and texture. And to do that, we need a larger size piece. This recipe calls for 4 cloves. These cloves are rather small. I feel like you can never really have too much garlic. The easiest way to peel garlic is you take your clove, put your end of your knife on top of it, give it a nice whack, and the peel comes right off. Then you can mince it however you like. All right, mushrooms are nicely browned. We're going to remove them into the bowl with has our chuck roast and bacon. And then next, we're going to put in 2 tablespoons of butter along with the 2 onions and the pound of carrots. We're gonna let the onions begin to translucent almost to the point of browning before we add, we move them to the outer edge, and we're gonna add some tomato paste. Okay, onions and carrots have begun to brown. We're gonna move them to the outside edge of the pot. We're going to add 2 tablespoons of tomato paste and our minced garlic, and we're gonna let that brown. Browning the tomato paste and the garlic enhances the flavor. The tomato paste is adding that acidic, slightly umami element to our stew, and it's definitely a step you do not want to miss. We are going to add our cup of wine. We're going to add 2 bay leaves, fresh or dried. We're going to chop 1/2 cup of flat leaf Italian parsley, and then we're going to add fresh thyme. Thyme you can do in 1 of 2 ways. You can pull off the little leaves. It can be a little bit tricky, and sometimes the stems kind of get in there. The other way is you can choose to tie your thyme bundle with a piece of butcher's twine and drop it in there like that. One reason we add the wine and let it reduce is, first, it concentrates the flavor a bit while it reduces, and then also it gives you an opportunity to scrape up all those tiny little brown bits of flavor that have accumulated while browning all of our meats. All right, our wine has reduced. We are going to add 3 cups of beef stock. Beef stock over beef broth. Beef stock is more intense in flavor. You can make it yourself, or you can buy good quality from the supermarket. We're going to also then add our herbs, bring everything up to a light simmer and cover it, and then let it simmer away for 2.5 hours. I'll see you then. All right, our stew has simmered to perfection. It's reduced a little bit. The beef is fork tender. Everything looks fabulous. I'm going to take it off the heat, and I have some fresh chopped parsley. We're gonna stir that in. We're going to slice our fresh bread, and then it's gonna be time to eat.